right, we're starting to feed back up, and this is going to be a special halftime show. Honor former Bret Hart player and fallen hero, Gavin Brummett. Gavin was killed in early June by an IED in Afghanistan with his unit. And they just held a memorial service. In fact, some of his family are back east right now in North Carolina for the service the military was holding for he and the other members of his unit.
Please all stand up and give a wave. We want to thank all of you for your service to our country. We'd also like to thank Marine Rick Ryan. Some of you might know him as the Walking Man of Murphy's. Rick's story is on thepinetree.net. We encourage everyone to read it. It's truly inspiring. Thank you also to all the men and women involved in tonight's tribute. We salute every one of you. You're awesome. Gavin meant so much to so many. Everyone out here has a connection to him in one way or another. We are also proud to have shared in his life. Thank you, Brummett Morris family. Gavin's wife, Michaela, and Father Greg couldn't be here tonight. They are in North Carolina at Camp Lejeune attending a memorial service for Gavin, but are watching this on the webcast thanks to John and Kim at thepinetree.net. I'm sure that they can all feel all the love for the family here tonight and all the way to North Carolina. Thank you again for coming. Everyone, please stand.
May I recite it and try to explain to you the meaning of each word. I, me, an individual, a committee of one, pledge, dedicate all of my worldly goods to give without self-pity, allegiance, my love and my devotion, to the flag, our standard, O glory, a symbol of freedom. Wherever she waves, there's respect, because your loyalty has given her a dignity that shouts freedom is everybody's job. United, that means that we have all come together. States, individual communities that have united into 48 great states. 48 individual communities with pride and dignity and purpose. All divided with imaginary boundaries, yet united to a common purpose. And that's love for country. And to the Republic. Republic. A state in which sovereign power is invested in representatives chosen by the people to govern. and government is the people. And it's from the people to the leaders, not from the leaders to the people, for which it stands. One nation, meaning so blessed by God, indivisible, incapable of being divided, with liberty, which is freedom, the right of power to live one's own life, without threats, fear, or some sort of retaliation. And justice, the principle or qualities of dealing fairly with others. For all. For all. Which means, boys and girls, it's as much your country as it is mine. And now, boys and girls, let me hear you recite the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Since I was a small boy, two states have been added to our country, and two words have been added to the Pledge of Allegiance: under God. Wouldn't it be a pity if someone said that is a prayer and that would be eliminated from schools too?
This is Carson Arrington, number 24 from your own Bret Hart Bullfrogs varsity football team. As you already know, tonight is a night to honor an awesome friend, brother, son, husband, and American hero, Gavin Brumund. I was lucky enough to be very close to Gavin and his family, gaining many memories that I will never forget. Gavin was well known by many throughout Bret Hart when he attended from 2002 to 2006 and graduated with the class of 2006. People knew him as being the nice, funny guy who brightened up a room as soon as he walked in, and many people enjoyed his company. I spent many days with Gavin and his family over the years, sharing many laughs and memories. Gavin was an awesome young man, and I am proud to say that I am dedicating my season to such a brave person. This season, I am wearing Gavin's number 82, on the back of my helmet, to honor a true American hero. To Gavin's parents, Debbie, Greg, and Chris, and his brother Cole, thank you for all that you have done for me, and I am glad to have all of you in my life. And to all that have come out tonight to support the Bret Hart football team and to be here to honor a true American hero, thank you. And I can promise you, your varsity football team will not disappoint you. Thank you, Gavin Brumund. You have fallen, but you have definitely not been forgotten.
Too disturbing for you and me. and just breathing. It's what the experts say. It was up to me, I'd show it every day. Some say this country is just out of looking for a fight. After 9/11, man, I'd have to say that's right. Have you forgotten how it felt that day? See your homeland under fire and her people blown away. Have you forgotten when those towers fell? We had neighbors still inside, going through living hell. Have you forgotten? I've been there with the soldiers who've gone away to war. You can bet that they remember just what they're fighting for. Have you forgotten all the people killed? Yes, some went down like heroes in that Pennsylvania field. Have you forgotten about our Pentagon? All the loved ones that we lost and those left to carry on. Don't you tell me not to worry about Bin Laden. Thank you.
Dark for a couple minutes while we get ready for the second half.